This is Luzira Murchison Bay Prison, the home to convicted petty offenders, suspects on remand, and some capital offenders transferred from the maximum security prison. Not sure of what awaits them inside the prison walls, these new arrivals, fresh from court, can only let the passage of time decide their fate. The prison wardens have to count to ascertain the number of the new inmates and check them before ushering them into the facility. The new arrivals will add to the 1,854 inmates already struggling for space in Uganda's second biggest male prison.
This prison was supposed to have like 600 prisoners, but you see we are operating around 3 times or 4 times. So we are overcrowded. And it's a very big challenge, and it affects all the services. It affects the number of staff because it affects the ratios.
Prison authorities say the number sometimes hits 2,000. The space problem is so bad that sometimes inmates can hardly find where to put their heads for a night's sleep.
The numbers in the wards are determined by the prisoners we get, but on average they are 30 to 60. But if the numbers go up, we add on more people.
This congestion also makes managing the inmates an arduous task, since the ratio of the inmates to prison warders is very high.
Because under normal circumstances, it's supposed to be a ratio of 1 to 3, but you find sometimes we go to 1 to 7, 1 to 8, and we don't have control. And getting staff, we cannot increase on the number of staff at pressure.
As they say, necessity is the mother of invention. So the prison officers at the facility have devised another way of managing the inmates.
We try to show them love. And the moment somebody knows that you love him, there are high chances that you'll secure his support. So they don't become violent. We listen to them and we show that we are actually there for them.
Once they get here, the inmates are taken through the do's and don'ts of the facility. But with the huge numbers here struggling for everything, some of these rules are inevitably broken, and this includes a few cases of fighting.
Once in a while they fight, but it's not common. It's not common. And more especially these ones who have just come from outside before they know how to live with others.
Cases of homosexuality have also been reported, but the authorities say this is being investigated. Interestingly, the huge numbers have not compromised the sanitation of the prison. The inmates are routinely counted for purposes of accountability and effective management.
One of the things you expect as an administrator, that a prisoner can escape. So you have to keep on checking, see whether your people are still there. Like the bankers, keep on checking on their money. You can't finish a day without balancing your books.
The authorities say prison breaks are not common, although some inmates try to escape when they are taken outside.
Yeah, it happens, but not from inside. Like maybe if they are going like to court, once in a while somebody can and leaves them. But there are very few. Like the whole of this year so far, we have had 2.
Despite these challenges, the prison service has largely kept the inmates in check. Solomon Serwanja, NTV.